and I was like the little brother coming and knowing nothing, and that was a kind of feeling. But very, of course, full of love and compassion and fraternity for me. But I really felt like the last little brother of 40 big brothers and sisters.
What's the biggest challenge you face being the last prophet?
The biggest challenge is all the forces on earth who try to destroy this creation. Everything else is nothing. The only thing which is important for me is what can make humanity fail and destroy itself. We now have, according to the Elohim, who observe the earth very carefully and everything happening, 86% chance of destroying ourselves. So that's a lot. But I am optimistic. I want to see only the percentage of chance we have to survive. And there is cosmic law which says that if a form of life on any planet reach a high level of science and technology but still have a very low level of spirituality and love and non-violence, then they destroy themselves. And when you discover a certain level of technology, and we are at it now, nuclear technology, you can destroy everything on Earth. And that's good. I mean, that's good because like that we don't propagate, spread in the universe our violence. If you have if the George Bush-style people prevail, try to imagine with the future technology what this kind of people can do. They can destroy the Earth completely. And so non-violent people, Gandhi-like people, peaceful people must prevail. And that's why the teaching of the Elohim is so much focused on the non-violence and the love and fraternity and respect for differences, different race, different religion, different any difference, and to live together with like a rainbow of color in every aspect of our life.
How can we as a human race on this planet harmoniously prepare for the future, for what is coming?
Do I have to repeat the question? Not necessarily.
Not necessarily.
Good. How can we prepare ourselves to enter the future world in a positive way and to embrace the 14% chance of surviving we have by destroying all the negative, violent, and disrespectful thought that were taught to us by the primitive religion, which is full of hatred for people who have a different races, different religion, different ethnic group, to really realize that the earth is a village and that we will survive all together or nothing. And the only choice we have is a planet full of love or destruction. And that's why love is so important. And what is love? It's not only the love of the church, we say love each other, love your neighbor. No, that's it did not work. We see it did not work. Because you have a world now where you have a billion of Muslims hating a Christian. A billion of Christians hating Muslim, and they all have a religion say love your neighbor, so it doesn't work. What work is using science and technology to make people realize scientifically that we are one race and that we must forget all the stupidity of the past, and we must not love our neighbor, we must love people who are of different race, different religion, on the other side of this planet. It's much more important because nationalism, fascism, which is winning slowly for some people like George Bush, try to make you think, love your nation first, love your city first, love your race first, and then we can maybe tolerate the others. This is terrible. We must love more the others than ourselves. We must love more if we are white, the black, if we are black, the white, if we are Christian, the Muslim. Like Gandhi, that was a beautiful time. One of the most beautiful history of his life is when he spoke with a man Hindi man whose child was killed by a Muslim, and who was saying, how can you be non-violent? My child was killed by a Muslim. What can I do to replace my child? He said, adopt a Muslim child. And that's beautiful. That's the only way to save the world, is to, instead of attacking Afghanistan and Iraq, George Bush could have said, let's adopt 1 million Arabic poor children. I'm sure terrorism will have ended instantly. Let's welcome 100,000 poor Palestinians in America. That's love. And it's completely the opposite of sending bomb. If we send bomb, we will get bomb. September 11 was nothing compared to what's coming if we continue to behave in an aggressive way. But if we open our heart, our doors, our borders, not closing it more and more like America is doing now, but receiving the world, helping the world, then the world is saved.
And how is the Raelian movement?
No, we have to stop. We're over time.
Can we get the seminar question?
No. The only thing, if you would like to answer, this is for the college, if you want to give a message to
for the students.
Student. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yes.
A message
with
for the
pleasure.
Students.
Okay. And you can look at me while I answer this question.
Okay. I'm very happy to talk with the student of your university because the students are the future. What I will tell you is don't listen to the old teachers. They are stupid, whatever they teach you. Listen to the young people. Amongst you, there are future Einstein, future geniuses in every field. And look at the internet. The internet is full of news, much more important than your teachers. Because your teachers, they were from 20, 30 years ago, so they are things of the past. And the science and technology and education is growing at a speed that make even somebody who got a diploma 10 years ago look like a dinosaur. So look to the future, reach the internet, find new discoveries. Every day you have new discovery. Subscribe to Rael Science. That's made for you, students. It's free. And what is Rael Science? It's a media. We collect around the world all the scientific news every day. And like that, you get it right from the horse's mouth instead of getting it through a university and teachers getting their diploma in the antediluvian era. And I wish you the best. The most important people to save the planet are you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. You want to get a summary answer?
The teacher will not be happy. I don't mind. I don't care.
One love. One
In 1997, scientists cloned a sheep named Dolly and shocked the world. The world of science. Well, today, Dolly is a mere scientific footnote, and a new cloning maverick gets ready to make history. Matt Walsh reports.
Nowadays, married couples are waiting longer than ever before deciding to have children. But this story is not about those people. It's about this man and his dream. Meet Randy Wicker, owner of an antique lighting boutique in Greenwich Village. His dream? To one day have a child. But with his biological clock ticking away and his gayness a foregone conclusion, Randy realized there was only one logical thing to do.
I would like to clone myself.
And with recent breakthroughs in cloning, all it would take is an unprecedented act of Congress, a monumental shift in ethical thought, and several medical miracles. Already, Randy has begun crunching the numbers.
How much will it cost for you to clone yourself?
Somewhere between $30,000 and $300,000.
Now, how do you plan on cloning yourself?
Could I just get a plug-in for my store, AmericanDeco.com? People spend years looking for certain shades.